Hello. A match made in heaven. Altrazo and Tamika Tiller are just that. They became husband and wife after falling in love and realizing they had common interests and dreams. They united their talent and formed Tiller Vision Production, a entertainment powerhouse. They are here to share their latest projects with us. Let's welcome Altrazo and Tamika Tiller, a power couple on the rise. Welcome, come on in. How you doing? Good to see you again.
Hello,
same here. Thanks for coming on the show.
Thank you for having us.
Okay, you're looking splendid.
Thank you.
All right. Hey, everyone, please stay tuned because we have an exciting show. So don't touch that dial. Hey, you.
Yeah, you. Getting that college education.
What are you going to do?
Graduate and take some office job?
Be like everybody else?
Or will you dare do something different?
Like be a teacher.
You could be my teacher.
You got the skills. The smarts.
Yes, you.
You could be the teacher I never forget.
That would be cool.
Does that corporate job even have recess?
What are you going to make of yourself?
What are you going to make of me?
Hello, here I am with this power couple on the rise for sure. Welcome. Yes, Tamika and Altrazo, I tell you, you are the busiest people I know. You have all this stuff that you're working on, and when you were here before, you talked about how you got together and everything. So I thought it was fitting to accent you as a couple because of the Valentine's week coming up and everything. But I tell you, you're doing great things.
Well, thank you. Yeah. Thank you so much.
You. Yes. We're and you all looking wonderful.
Thank you.
You look Valentine-y yourself.
You look
Thank you. So I'm excited about your new project. Let's talk about it, you know?
We're pretty excited about it, too.
Okay, it's a new play.
It's a new play called Ho.
Okay.
And let me explain before anybody gets all out of sorts. Well,
okay.
Ho, basically we base this play off the Bible story about Hosea and Gomer. Hosea was a disciple of Christ, and Gomer was to, well, Hosea was to take Gomer as his wife, but she's a prostitute. Now, the name is basically based on Hosea.
A lot of people
get thrown off.
Right.
Pastor Ho is one of the characters in our play. But there is, it's intentional because his wife is a prostitute.
So it's a double meaning in a sense.
Yes, basically.
Okay.
And we don't want to give too much
all
away.
Right.
He's
okay.
Looking at me like.
Okay.
No.
Well, you know. That is interesting because when I first saw the flyer on Facebook and I said, oh, I mean, is that the right ho?
Right.
And then I saw the sexy lady, you know, mm-hmm. with the leg. I love the advertisement. I said,
Thank you. That
was boss. I really thought that was good. I said, no, they're up to something here.
Mm-hmm.
I got to find out what it is, you know.
Right.
So, but it's great because I know you have great faith, both of you.
Yes.
Absolutely.
So
absolutely.
You're trying to spread the word and tell the story because this is a really based upon the Bible, like you say, right?
Yeah. Well, it's in a sense.
In a sense,
yes. It's a modern day depiction, but it is in our way. We're telling the story in our own way. So it won't be exactly how it went down in the Bible, but very, very similar. So, it's very interesting. I mean, when you look at the title, I personally wanted to add a caption to the...
What would that have been?
I was going to say a modern-day story based on the Bible story of Hosea and Gomer. But, you know, my husband here was like, no, we're just going to put it out there as Ho.
Okay.
Ho
and I'm glad we did.
It's catchy. And people's minds can go in all kinds of direction. and make them very curious. I think it's a nice advertising strategy. I mean,
thank you. Thank you.
Because honestly, it is good. What it is.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's what it is. So.
Yeah.
All right. So everybody's going to run out and see the play and everything. But, you know, my audience is very, very fortunate today. They get to experience a little skit with the original cast. They're all here, everyone. So, hey, hold on to your seats and stay tuned.
I'm not supposed to be here.
And where do you think you're going?
I need to go home.
Go home?
To my husband.
You committed yourself here.
No, no, no. It wasn't me. You don't understand. It wasn't me. It wasn't me.
You're no longer go-go. You're a hoe.
No. No, no, you don't understand. It's not me.
Grab her. Andromeda is not going to like it.
I know that. She's my sister. You stay here. Relax.
That's it.
Just
That's
relax.
It.
Don't fight it.
That's it.
Stand up. Calm yourself.
What do you want me to do?
I want you to go with her. To your room.
And you'll be my pet.
Mother Tucker, at some point you had to have been happy with him. I mean, you guys have been together since I was a little boy. You've had so many wonderful years together.
We've had so many years together, but they haven't been wonderful.
Well, what about the three children he gave you?
I tried to give them back.
Well, Mother Tucker, realistically, if this marriage does dissolve, are you looking to get married again? I mean, if I may be frank, this isn't your first time on the merry-go-round. I mean, if I can recall correctly, this is your fourth marriage.
You're right. I love them and leave them. Stick and move, Pastor. Stick and move. I guess you're right. I do miss my ex-husbands, though.
Greetings and salutations, Pastor. It is my distinct honor to be here on this glorious day. And I see that you're doing charity work. Let it not be said that the sea now have no place in today's society. How are you today, Dirty Mother Tucker?
I was fine until you got here, diva.
You guys, you have to stop this, really, seriously. Mother Tucker, here's the number that we talked about. Give him a call. He's available anytime after 2 p.m. Tell him I referred you.
Okay, Pastor. I'll be sure not to call. Thanks for nothing. God bless y'all. Not you, Deke. Not you.
Oh, my. What a not-so-lovely woman. Her rambunctious spirit is equally yoked with her uncontested will to rain havoc on whoever shall dare cross paths with her.
What?
She's mean, Pastor.
Well, why didn't you just say that in the first place?
I beg your pardon, Pastor, but that is precisely what was implied in my candid phrasing.
You know what, Deke? Never mind. Did you get the information I asked you for?
Well, it seems that your missus may be willfully dwelling at a rather unsavory place where the female species partake in organized, unclothed bodily exercise in exchange for currency.
Dick, what in the world are you talking about? And what are you trying to say about my wife?
Well, my informant tells me that, Pastor, he's right outside. I shall retrieve him so that you may have word.
Hey, I'm back after enjoying that beautiful, beautiful skit by the cast of Ho. And here they are on the set looking beautiful. And I just, you know, I'm really happy to have you all on the show.
We're happy to be here. Thank you.
Yes. Now, my pleasure. Now, I want either Tamika or Altrezzo or both of you introduce your members and then they can tell me how they got into this project.
Okay, well, I'll start on this end. Right here at the far left is our main character who plays Pastor Ho. His name is Terrell.
Okay.
And we have Miss Go-Go here. She plays Go-Go, the Ho.
Oh.
And Okay. And her name is Jay Harper, Terrell Martin. And then back here, we have, I'm going to let you introduce her. Back here, we have Robert Short, and he plays dual characters, a snitch named Mitch.
A snitch.
And the gatekeeper.
Oh.
Back here, we have Gwen Hudson, and she plays Mother Tucker.
She's the mother of the group?
She's, well,
yeah. Well, I mean, but not in the real sense of the word, though.
Well, she's
another sense.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, behind me, we have Mr. Lamar Kemp. He plays Pastor Ho's right-hand man, Deke, a very fun character. And to my right, we have the lovely, beautifully talented Ms. April Washington. She's the choreographer of Ho.
Oh, right.
Very important
okay.
part.
Very, very important
hey,
part.
Hey, very impressive cast.
Thank you.
Very good looking cast.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, boy, this is going to be exciting. I can't wait to go see it. And this is going to be in April the 1st?
Yes.
Correct.
April the 1st?
April 1st at okay. Bunch Auditorium.
Okay. All right. So, how many days is it going to be?
It's just going to be that Saturday, but we have two shows, one at 3 p.m. and one at 7 p.m.
Oh, okay.
Wow. For now.
Well, maybe you can take it to Broadway, you know.
That's the plan.
Yeah. That's the
That's
plan.
Right. That's what I did when I, Shelley Garrett in L.A., his first cast members was on my show in L.A. First beauty shop
wow.
on my show.
Awesome.
Wow.
Yes. Yeah, so I have a history, so, you know, you all will be going to Broadway and doing everything too, huh?
Speak it.
And then
right?
Absolutely. Speak it.
Yes.
That'll be great. That'll be great. Okay, now, first of all, tell me how did you become involved? And you saw the cast call and you just went to it, or, you know,
well,
is
actually,
that what happened to you?
Actually, I worked with the Tillers and on another project before this one, and I was blessed and gracious enough that they considered me, handpicked me for this role.
Oh, okay.
And actually wrote this role with me in mind.
Really?
Yes. And they contacted me and asked me would I be interested in taking the part.
Okay. My question is, why did they have you in mind for this role?
I'm a spiritual man. I'm a man of faith.
Oh, okay.
And I believe that they, when they wrote this, and because Pastor Ho is a man of faith, they figured that, hey, the person to play this part would be Terrell and somebody to embody that role. And I feel that, you know, I'm blessed and honored that they even consider me to be a part of the production.
I'm sure you'll do a great job because of what we saw already. Yes. And let's talk with the young lady that's been labeled.
Jay.
No.
Okay. Tell us about yourself.
I met the Tillers at the first audition for When the Sin Hits the Fan. And when I went in there, I took my whole self in there. I'm a full body actor, so I was like, I'm gonna walk in and you're gonna see me today.
Okay. So you played the role when you first went
yes,
there?
Yes, when I first went, but it wasn't for this production, it was a previous production.
Okay.
I went in there and it's so funny because they said, hold on 1 second. And they came back and they said, I just want you to know that we want you for this part. And ever since then, Tamika says, I have you in mind for so many things. She was just like, don't worry. I got you. And I said, okay, you know, I love Tamika and Traz. Like, I believe her when she says that, you know? So when she called me up, she was just like, we have this play that we're doing and we want you to be a part. I was like, yep.
Ready to go.
Oh, of course.
Okay.
Of course. They're always professional. They always do great work. Their writing is phenomenal. So
me
as a real actor, how can I deny, you know?
Okay. Yeah. Wow. Yes. This is going to be good. I can't wait to see you play that role, honey.
Oh,
that's
going to
be something
Thank
else.
Thank you.
Powerful.
Powerful?
Powerful.
All right. Okay. Now let's park. Who else? How about you being the choreographer of the group?
Well, I actually met Tamika and Shelley Garrett's play Beauty Shop. Got an opportunity to tour last year with him, and hopefully that thing is going to go back on the road again this year. I was a dancer slash actress, and that is how we got close. And I actually met him in the same place. So when she reached out to me and asked me if this was something that I wanted to be a part of, I knew I did, because I know that in our rehearsals with Shelly Garrett, these two were taking notes. And we all know how great Shelly Garrett is. So
right.
If anybody is inspiring to go in that type of direction, then that's the boat that I want to be on.
All right. Mm-hmm. Well, hey, you're in great company and doing quite well. Because that's how I met Tamika. She was here with Shelly Garrett when they were the 25th anniversary, I believe, at that time. And that's how I met Tamika. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and we've been corresponding ever since. On Facebook and everything else. Yeah. So, okay, now how about you? Looking like a model, Robert.
I actually met Tamika and Traz doing another production as well with another company, and they came to the show and enjoyed her brother's performance.
Okay.
You know, it was fun, and so we just kind of talked a little bit after that, and Traz pretty much offered me the role, and then he enjoyed it, and then offered me another role.
Oh, okay.
Then he enjoyed that, so we've been going forward with it after that ever since then. So,
okay.
Yes.
All right. Well, that's how they do in Hollywood, I know, because I had the cast members of the Five Heartbeats on my show in L.A., and they were all here. They're doing the same thing, the same people be using their talent, you know, Robert Townsend. Once they get someone that they know does a certain caliber of work, they always got them, you know, on their mind. And, you know, that's how they do. So great. So what about you, my dear?
I'm Gwen Hudson, and I am thrilled to be in the company of all of these great actors. I met the Tillers on one of their other projects. I was blessed to be cast, and they called me for a second time, and I'm so happy to be here.
Oh, well, you can't beat that. And you, boy, handsome men in here. Okay.
Thank you. Lamar Kemp II. I, like Rob, I was lucky enough for the Tillers to be in attendance to our production that we were in. Mm-hmm. And right afterwards, they came up and said, "Hey, we think we got something for you."
Uh-huh,
and I said,
uh-huh.
I had no idea who they were, but I could feel the power come off of these folks. So I was like, "All right, well, great. I look forward to hearing from you."
Okay.
But I think it was less than a week later that Traz called me and he said, "Hey, can you talk?" I said, "Yep, I can talk." And after the end of that conversation, it was a done deal. So, I'm honored to be here.
Hey, very happy to have you all on the show. You know, we're going to come back, you know, after this. So, everyone, stay tuned.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life.
Do not. Here I come.
Take time to be a dad today.
Daddy, I'm
gonna
find you.
Hello, I'm back. We're just having a fabulous time with these beautiful people and talented people. I mean, this studio is just full of goodness. My goodness.
Thank you.
Yes, and let's talk more about the play. I know you don't want to give it away and all, but you're going to talk about what it took for you to write. Now, you both of you wrote the play, right?
Yes. Correct.
Okay, so how hard was that?
Actually, and surprisingly to us, it was not as hard as we thought it would be. And the way we did it, the way it gelled, it just rolled out perfectly. Like, I think this man is a writer. He's a bona fide writer. And he'll come up with ideas, and then I kind of, like, bring them to life. But how we both did this time was, I think I started off writing. You gave me an idea, and I put it into the script format. And he'd go to work, and I'd go to work, or vice versa. But when we came home, he'd start where I left off.
Oh.
And we'll each go over what we wrote with each other. And while we're doing that, we just start getting more ideas. And it was like, oh, we should do this. Okay, that's what I'm going to write tomorrow, because it would be my turn to write or his turn to write. So that's basically how it flowed. And I think when we got towards the end, we started having a little power struggle right there.
Yeah, we had different ideas on how it would end. But the irony of it all is that Tamika and I never sat beside each other and wrote this play. Mm. It was, I would write my part and go to work and leave it on the bed beside her. And when I got home, she would have hers, and we read each other's stuff and then, you know, bounce ideas off of each other. But we never literally sat down and wrote the play together.
That's
which is probably
something.
A good thing, you know.
Yeah, well, I guess.
Yeah.
That wouldn't have worked.
And it's like she said, when we got to the end, it, you know, it was like, no, it should do this and it should do that.
Oh,
but,
okay.
We compromised.
Did you come to, compromise.
Absolutely.
Oh, okay.
Absolutely. But the ending is, I'm proud of it. It's awesome. It's powerful. I thank God for this woman because she, like she said, she takes my ideas and just catapults them. You know, she colors them. And we complement each other well.
Oh,
we complement each other very well.
What a blessing. You two are blessed to have each other, to love each other, to be married, and to share the same interests and be talented. Both of you are talented. You know, you add to the whole process, you know.
Thank you.
And that is really a blessing to have that. Not everybody have that. You
true.
Know, and
that's true.
Most people don't have that, come to think of it, you know, so
right.
That's really great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We come up with a lot of really great ideas together. Like just yesterday, we were on Facebook having a conversation with a young lady, and then boom, we got another idea, something
okay.
that we're going to start working on. I think immediately after.
Right after Ho is done.
Ho is done. But even with that, we have other productions that we're going to prepare to put on. One being The Ballad of Sweet Auburn. And this young man and this young lady back here, they both were in that and will be again. But that's just, you know, one of the other things that we have going.
Down the pipeline, huh?
Pretty excited about this one, though. I think this one is going to probably run a little longer than we think it is sitting
okay.
here
yeah.
right now.
The popularity of Ho?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Everybody has their funny little catchphrases. We got to go see that Ho.
Yeah.
You know, different things like that. So it's I think, like, even with the choreography, and that's where April comes in, the way we sat down and met with her and gave her our ideas of how we want these dances to go. And they're really spiritual, like demons and light and darkness dancing, you know, and bringing more color to the story. And this is something different, you know, for Traz and I. This production is on a different level. We never really had dancers and then somebody so professional to come in and put our thoughts and ideas together and just bring it to life. So we're really excited about people seeing it.
And it helps that she's a visionary.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
we told her our concept and like literally right there on the spot, she was like, well, how about this? Or this is what I'm seeing. And you know, I'm not a control freak, but I don't like anybody necessarily taking over.
Mm-hmm.
But when April, I just sat back.
Yeah, we both were like,
I was just like, wow. Yeah, that's great. So it's incredible. Hey, you wanna chime in?
Okay. So how did you get into the business of being a choreographer in the first place?
Oh wow, that's extremely funny. I used to weigh 200 pounds.
What?
So yeah, I went on this extreme weight loss journey. Y'all don't know that. I went on an extreme weight loss journey, and in that journey, I figured out that I love fitness. So from there, I decided I was going to do Zumba, and I wanted to be this huge Zumba instructor. So my head let me network to the best. So I go and try out an audition for a Zumba video, and I meet the choreographer there, and I fall in love.
Mm-hmm.
Totally forget why I'm even there to begin with. At the end of that audition, I came up to her and I was like, what is your name? And her name was Morgan Flowerchild, who was also in a play with us, with Shelley Garrett. And mm-hmm. I told her that day, I was like, I don't know what to do, but I want to do it for you. Mm-hmm. And from that day forward, which is 4 years ago, I started dancing professionally immediately.
Wow. So, you know,
and through all that learning, that dancing and that training that I got through Flower Child Productions, it showed me something that I love that I did not have any idea or clue that I love. And dancing wow. brought me into Amazing. Acting. So it just, you know, just me trying to put my best foot forward in every avenue actually opened a door that I was not even planning to visit.
Wow.
You know, so it was very amazing, just the trip that I've gone on. So when I'm dancing with Flower Child, just learning with her throughout all the years, that helped me to open up my mind and expand more and, you know, use my creativity. And mm-hmm. and that is why I love choreographing pieces. It allows me to take people's visions, people's words, and put it into movements. And that's how my mind amazing. Sees things.
What a story. You know, that's a testimony. Really? Really?
Can I say yes. one more thing? Yes. There are a couple of cast members that aren't here, so I'd like to give them recognition.
Them,
we've got Kevin Smith, Martinez J,
Frederica
Kinlow, and Brianna Dowdell. So we want to say hi, guys, and you know, unfortunately, scheduling conflicts,
we'll
they couldn't make it.
We'll
and Jasmine Wade.
Jasmine Wade,
I'm sorry.
Wade. Okay. Yes. Well, we know that means everybody has to go and see the whole play, so they know who wasn't up here. Right.
They're all phenomenal. You're in for
uh-huh.
a treat.
Yeah,
okay. Absolutely. Well, you know, thank you for taking time out to come on the Charlie Moore Show and share your talent and your beauty and your enthusiasm on the show. And I want you to break a leg, but not really, but break a leg as far as the theater says. Break a leg. Have a great show, and I hope to see it.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Well, I know it was a good show, so you got what you wanted. And please tune in again next week for more with more.